Hey, this is Buff Bagwell, and I want you to go out and subscribe to Wolf Steiner Customs.
Yo, what is up, Wolfpack? Wolf Steiner Customs back here with another video, and today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make a Freddy Krueger bust. If you guys don't know what a bust is, it's basically a little display stand or just a little... It's almost like a statue of a horror person. It doesn't have to be horror, but mine is going to be Freddy Krueger. It can be anyone, as long as you have a mask or some sort. You can make it, you know? It's basically has from the chest up, or half the chest up. So it's almost like a life size, but it's not the whole body. It's just, you know, the upper. But anyways, I'm going to be going ahead and teaching you how to make one. So first off, what you're going to need... I would recommend probably like a better plastic one than a styrofoam one because it does fall apart easily. This is just my, you can use just displays. You can like display them for just regular masks, as you can see with this Jason custom Freddy Krueger mask. But anyways, if we remove that, that's what you need. I got this at Hobby Lobby for like, about like $5. It does work, but as when you do see my Freddy Krueger one, you can see a lot of it does break off very easily from the mask. So I would recommend like a plastic one online. I'm sure it's a little more expensive, but it's probably worth it. And it's probably easier to paint than it is a styrofoam one, because you'll see what I did with my Freddy Krueger one. But yeah, Hobby Lobby, and that's all you need. And now I'll show you guys my Freddy Krueger one. As you can see, the nose broke off already. So basically... You know, it probably doesn't look like him. I was just doing random stuff. I was trying to make it look like the Joker. But mainly what you're going to want is the nose and the eyes be painted and around the eyes. So I painted the eyes and I sculpted, as you can see, all that sculpt work right there from the burn marks. And it maybe does look bad. I will admit myself that it does look bad without a mask on. It looks like... absolute trash, but once you put that mask on, it does give it so much more detail and more character. As you can see, the nose already broke off when I was trying to remove the mask for this video. That's why I think, and some of the ears, as you can see. Not that it matters, because his ears aren't even, you know, normal. They're kind of just holes on the side of his head. Let me tell you, I'm doing this off of the remake Freddy. So that's why he has one blue eye and one brown eye, because that's what it is in the movie. And it does look pretty bad on here, but as you can see, this eye is like a little bit more, I guess, smaller than this eye, because in the movie, his left eye, my right eye when I'm looking at this, but from his point of view, this is his left eye, and it's more, has more burn marks around it, so it doesn't look like a normal eye. This eye kind of does look a little bit more normal, but this one isn't, and it's brown. As you see, there's a lot of sculpting done around it, so, you know, I made it more accurate. And next, what you're going to do is get your mask and go ahead and put it on. So I'll go ahead and put this on. All right, guys, so we got the mask on. As you can see, it looks so much better. The eyes do look pretty realistic from where I'm looking at it, but like I said, without the mask off, it looks like a whole different story. But honestly, I think the eyes did turn out good, because it does give, like, good, you know, personality or character to Jackie, the one who played the new Freddy, the remake one. And honestly, a lot of people hate that movie, but I thought it was better than the first one, the original. I mean, I will say his voice was not the greatest at all. Definitely got to go with Robert Englund when it comes to the voices, but the Freddy in general, I think he was almost like awkward. It was really awkward when he would come up, but honestly, the movie itself told a better story, and of course, better graphics and better technology they can do with. I know a lot of people hate this movie, but in my opinion, it's one of my favorites. But yeah, that's from the head, and then as you see, it goes down. Try and get a mask that includes the neck, because it will, make sure you get a mask that covers like the full head, not just half head. And it does include the neck, because, you know, it just makes it so much better, and you'll see what I mean. But yeah, make sure you paint around the eyes. As you can see, there's no white in it, because if it is white, then you'll be able to tell that you used, you know, a mannequin head. But yeah, So there's that. And of course, next we need Freddy's signature hat. So I got this at Party City. So I'm going to put that on. Looks good. Probably more downwards. Like that. It doesn't have to be perfect right now because we're not completely finished. But yeah, that's what it looks like already, guys. And that's without even the chest or anything. So yeah, Freddy Krueger. Now let's go ahead and get on to, you know, making the bust itself. Okay, so what you're going to need is a box. I don't know the measurements, but just about a size. This looks about 17 inches wide, so something like that. But yeah, this is just an Undertaker box from his commemorative urn from WWE Shop. We don't need to worry about the inside. But make sure on the inside you have like some sort of like hole inside of it, so it's not just a regular box. Because you'll see what I mean when you put the actual like shirt or whatever itself in. But anyways, now we're gonna go and get onto the shirt, and this is just a regular Freddy Krueger sweater from Party City or Spirit Halloween. Now, usually people cut it up, but I'm definitely gonna probably be wearing this again, so I don't want to cut it up. But what we're gonna do is we're just gonna. This is why I'm saying you need a hole, because if you put the box inside the shirt, just like that, and then kind of just like I'm doing, just stuffing it inside that hole so it's not really too noticeable, and try and get it straight. So just what I'm doing. And once we do that, make sure you get where the neck is on the center, just like that. So there's like a circle and on the top of your box. And then kind of just stuff the rest underneath so it won't be too noticeable until where it's just like a box. So yeah, just like that. Okay, and then next what we're gonna need is some stuffing. Mainly cotton, or you can, you know, get some out of a teddy bear or whatever. This is actually the spiderweb stuff they use in Halloween. You can get it at party stores or online. This is what I had laying around. It's pretty much just like cotton. Just, it can stretch out. But anyways, we're going to be stuffing it around the inside like that, so it looks like his shoulders. So I'm going to go ahead and get this stuffed, and I'll see you guys in a little bit. Alright, so after we got it stuffed, it is starting to look like, you know, like a shoulder or whatever. We're not going to worry about the arms. Some people do include one arm, but I'm not going to do it. Most people don't really include arms, but I think it looks cool without arms anyways. Now, all we have left to do is put the mask itself on the inside, and then, you know, we'll be done. So let me go ahead and put this bad boy on, and I'll see you guys in a second. Alright, so we are done after we put the mask inside, and I think it looks absolutely amazing. It's not professional. I know some people use like professional kind of boxes or whatever. But I'm obviously not a professional. But I think mine looks good for the first time. And if you want to do something at home real quick, I think it works for sure. Hope this video was helpful, because not many people make videos about these, and I've always kind of struggled. So I just went ahead and made my own, and I think it looks awesome. Like I said, you guys can do this at home, just a little fun activity if you're bored or whatever. But yeah, make sure you like, comment, subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out. Too sweet.